I don't want to waste your time, so there won't be an intro. When you ask Pro League fans about their least favorite maps, Consulate will pretty much always be in the top two. People say that it's a linear and boring map with a stale meta, and there is certainly some truth to that. But in general, I disagree. There is actually a surprising amount of variety in Consulate's meta game. And today, I want to show you a new lobby piano attack that recently gained a lot of popularity, to the point where it's now the preferred alternative for a lot of NA teams. I'm talking about a piano focus take where you ultimately either drop down CEO hatch or rappel into piano through the windows. If your first reaction is, that is impossible, then honestly, I don't blame you. Because at first glance, there are like four different things that prevent you from doing that. The most obvious is probably a player in bathroom holding their hatch and being ready to peek the piano windows. And that might seem like a pretty big problem. But it turns out that a bathroom player is actually not able to consistently prevent attackers from rappelling into piano. Of course, that is somewhat hard to believe, because all he needs to do is to wait for the sound cue and then swing. But here, it's very important to consider this situation in the context of a real round. Because in a real round, there are a number of things that make it really difficult to swing off of a sound cue. There's gunfire, there are flashbangs, there are callouts, and maybe there's even pressure from Yellow Stairs or Garage. So in the end, the attackers can almost always safely rappel into piano. That is, of course, as long as there isn't a second defender in the ante corner. If you've never heard of ante, that's the room that is connecting lobby, bathroom and piano. And this guy very much is a problem. Not just for the rappel, but also for the plant. Obviously, our idea for this attack is to get into piano and then plant the bomb. But that is very awkward if we need to worry about an ante player. So we need to come up with something to deal with that. Similarly, the third potential problem also has to do with planting, and its defenders peeking from yellow stairs. These guys don't really matter for the rappel, but once you are in and you're trying to plant, there are a lot of spots that a yellow player can deny. So now we talked about how defenders can deny the plant from bathroom, ante or yellow stairs, but there is actually one more way of doing that. The fourth problem is defenders playing in CEO, where they have holes in the floor in order to hold the piano windows from above. Alright, so now that we are aware of the problems, we need a way to solve them. And here, I actually want to show you two strategies. The way Dark Zero is playing it, and the way that TSM is playing it. The reason I'm showing you two is that even though both strategies solve the same problems, they're doing it in an entirely different way. And that becomes apparent very early on in the round. Right here, for example, Dark Zero's setup doesn't even look like a piano take. It looks much more like a CEO take. And that's because it is a CEO take. Dark Zero is ultimately trying to get into piano by dropping down the CEO hatch. And obviously, they need CEO control for that. Interestingly, that also means that they already solved the fourth problem. If the attackers have control of CEO, the defenders can't be in there to deny the plant vertically. Now, let's take a look at how TSM is approaching the situation. As you can see, it immediately looks much more like a piano take. And that is mainly because TSM doesn't clear CEO. Instead, they only have Chala on CEO rappel. But if you think about it, that of course also solves the problem. So, okay, both teams have now made sure that defenders can't play in CEO. Next up on the list is the anti-corner. And here, it becomes very apparent why Dark Zero went through all that trouble of actually taking control of CEO. By opening the floor here, they can very easily clear out that pesky anti-corner, and most importantly, they can keep control of it. If another defender rotates in later on in the round, then they are already in position to deal with it. For TSM, however, that is not the case, because they are using nades to clear anti. But not the boring kind from outside the window. Those can of course work, but they are very telegraphed and potentially weak to an ADS stack. Instead, TSM nades from below. You will always see Achieved entering Garage on his own, and then they have Merc on anti-repel to trap the defender in that corner, where they then eventually kill him. Okay, so at this point, both teams have solved the CEO problem and the ante problem. Now, let's move on to the yellow desk problem. Going back to Dark Zero, they basically get that for free, right? If you have CEO control, you also have top yellow control. So defenders aren't really playing around that bottom yellow area anyways. That being said, they do have Eclipse outside yellow stairs. That mainly protects against runouts in the early game, but in the late game, that can be very good against defenders that are lurking around the bottom yellow area. Looking at TSM, they kind of follow a similar approach, but obviously they don't have map control. So instead of taking proper control of that area, they time the piano execute with Sledge coming up yellow or spiral stairs. Look at this round. Achieved is on spiral stairs, Geo is on CEO repel to deny the CEO holes, and Pojo is in piano trying to get the plant down. And now, Achieved hits the perfect timing on peeking towards yellow. And even if he didn't hit the timing perfectly, as long as he isn't late to the party, he can always at least distract the defenders. Alright. So that was how both teams managed to solve the problems of a piano take. Now, let me go back and put everything into a coherent order so you can see both attacks in their entireties, starting with TSM's way of doing it. As you can see, their setup is pretty straightforward. We are 1 minute into the round, and they have Jackal on CO repel, Ace on piano repel, Hibana on anti repel, Sledge in garage, and Sophia in spawn. Now, that last one might seem kind of odd, but the idea here is to prevent projector and lobby runouts. And really, the only way to do both at the same time is to be this far back in spawn. As you can see, there are holes in CO above the windows, but that doesn't really matter because they have Jackal on CO repel. Then, you can see both Hibana and Sledge being in position to deal with a potential anti-player, for example, with a nade from below. Now, in this particular round, Dark Zero doesn't play that position, so Sledge moves on to the next step, which is being in position to help against bottom yellow pressure. And with that, TSM is basically ready to execute. Now pay close attention to what Geo does here. By shooting towards Anti, he hides the sound of Hibana repelling into piano, and as you can see, Meluzzi wasn't fast enough to react to it. Then we also see Bolo moving closer to lobby, because now with Hibana and Ace being in piano, his main job is to make sure that the defenders can't use lobby to retake Anti. The plant is going down, and here you can again see what Sledge is up to. In this particular round, the timing is a bit unlucky, but if Hibana didn't get that kill, Sledge certainly would've. And because Sledge is where he is, Mute is now kind of forced to try and retake from lobby, which is where he runs into Bolo. And by this point, the round is obviously long over. In fact, it was probably over as soon as Hibana got that kill in bathroom. But I think that round did a really good job of showing TSM's strategy in action. Now, let's do the same thing for Dark Zero's way of playing. Again, we are about a minute into the round, and we can already see the striking difference. Because, again, unlike TSM, Dark Zero is actually trying to take map control, at least up until CEO. With this attack, they basically don't care about defenders playing in projector or long desk. Hashtag foreshadowing. Anyways, so by taking CEO control, they dealt with the first problem of defenders playing vertical angles. And they also set up the solution to the second problem, which is defenders playing in anti. Because with both Buck and Sophia opening the floor in CEO, they can easily force defenders out of piano and, more importantly, out of anti. With that accomplished, Dark Zero is basically ready to execute. And again, they make good use of their map control. Eclipse walks into yellow, gets the kill on Maestro in bathroom, but then, importantly, immediately focuses on bottom yellow to prevent the flank. Meanwhile, we see Mint taking care of the other side of that bottom yellow area by smoking off benches, and then there's the actual execute. Ace dropped down CEO hedge and is currently planting, and if Maestro was still alive, he would have been perma-flashed here, and he probably wouldn't have been able to deny the plant. Okay, so that was the main idea behind Dark Zero's attack. Granted, they don't always finish the round in that exact way, but the general idea of the strategy is always the same. Now, you might be wondering why we are still stuck on this freeze frame. And the reason is that I now want to talk about the weaknesses of both attacks. If you pay really close attention to this particular situation, you're going to realize that Dark Zero is actually in a terrible position. because while that plan was going on, TSM managed to retake CEO and then denied the plan from above. And that is probably the single biggest weakness of this attack, because this CEO retake is most certainly not an isolated incident. There are a lot of rounds where Dark Zero is struggling with exactly that, and that shouldn't really come as a surprise. I mean, if you only take control of CEO and ignore Projector and Long Desk, this will just always be a threat. So in that sense, TSM's way of playing seems to be much simpler and also much safer. I mean, if you never take map control, then you can also never lose to a retake. That being said, there are of course a few downsides to TSM's attack. For example, when it comes to denying vertical holds in CEO. A few minutes ago, I said that a simple CEO repel was enough to make these holds unusable. But that's not entirely true. There is actually one hole that can be played from front desk without needing to expose yourself to the CEO window, and that is something that TSM just can't reliably deal with. But it's also not a deal breaker. You can only see one window, and if you hold that angle for the entire round, you're going to get slapped by the attacker on piano rappel. A much more concerning issue of TSM's attack is that their anti-control is not permanent. If Sledge doesn't get the kill with his nades, or if a defender manages to rotate back into anti in the late game, things look kind of rough for TSM, and they are forced to make desperation plays such as Sophia pushing into lobby. That is a problem that Dark Zero just don't have, because with their holes in the floor of CO, they have permanent control of that corner. So maybe a good way of summarizing both attacks is to say that Dark Zero is playing a complicated but clean attack, while TSM's approach is simpler but also a bit muddy. Think about TSM's solution to the yellow stairs problem, for example. Having Sledge walk up yellow or spiral stairs is very simple, in the sense that there is not much that can go wrong in the setup. But then, during the actual execute, Sledge is kind of a liability. If he dies or misses his timing, the entire attack is in jeopardy. So in the end, it's really a question of preference. Dark Zero's attack is more difficult to play, but TSM's attack is a bit more reliant on 50-50 gunfights. For me personally, I actually think that TSM's attack is better. I just really like how it's so simple, yet so effective. And here, it's important to point out that simplicity is not a bad thing. In fact, it's a good thing. You want your strategies to be simple, because that means that there are fewer opportunities for things to go wrong. I do think that from a theory perspective, Dark Zero's attack makes sense. But between taking yellow and CO control, playing vertically, preventing retakes, and setting up the execute, there is just so much that can go wrong. At the same time, TSM is solving exactly the same problems, but they are much more efficient at it. So ultimately, I think TSM's strategy is the superior piano take. But I still think it was very interesting to compare the two. After all, piano takes have only recently become popular, so we still see every team putting their own little spin on it. And I think that the meta for this attack is far from being solved. So I'm very much looking forward to every game on Consulate that we might be seeing in the next few months. Alright, that's it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you learned something new, and thanks for watching.